As we serve the Lord today, we are to scatter the seed everywhere, and this is necessary because we do not know people's hearts. This fact was the basis for Paul's point about Revelation in his letter to the church in Corinth, when he said, "For who among men knows the thoughts of a man except the spirit of the man which is in him? Even so the thoughts of God, no one knows except the Spirit of God," 1 Corinthians 2 and verse 11. We cannot know the mind of God unless He reveals it to us, any more than we can understand the minds and the hearts of other individuals unless they disclose that information to us as well. As the heart of potential hearers are different, the results of the sowing, meaning the teaching of the Word of God, will vary depending upon the reception of the hearers. We're taught in 2 Corinthians 5:11 that we are to persuade others. Notice that does not say that we are to force others. We cannot force people to respond to the gospel. Therefore, our responsibility is to plant the seed. Paul said, "I planted, Apollos watered, but God gave the increase," 1 Corinthians 3:6. If it is clear that despite our efforts that someone or some group will not be receptive to the gospel, then Jesus tells us in Matthew 10 and verse 14 that we need to shake the dust off of our feet and move on. But as we noted at the end of yesterday's lesson, we need to be working to cultivate the soil that is around us. That means cultivating the hearts of those that we come into contact with. But how do we do this? Well, we understand that we cannot judge the hearts of people, and this is why we sow the seed everywhere. However, we can learn more about people as we get to know them. So what can we do to make the less receptive hearts more receptive to the gospel? Well, let's go back to the parable of the sower for just a moment. Let's think about those that fall by the wayside or on the side of the road. For those who are uninterested, distracted, and preoccupied, we need to be persistent and encouraging of them. It may be a while before they become interested. So we ought to regularly bring up spiritual things in a persistent but not pushy way. We can be an example in showing a consistent interest in spiritual things, in showing them that we attend worship assemblies, that we attend Bible studies, and that we invite them to go along with us. But what about those who fall on stony ground among the rocks? For those who are short-sighted and not fully committed, we need to be honest in acknowledging the difficulties we might face. At the same time, we should be ready to remind them of the trouble that's caused by sin, about the benefits of godliness and the hope of eternal life. We should be an example of commitment to the Lord through the difficulties that we personally face. But also, what about those that are on the thorny ground? Those who are worldly minded and have misplaced priorities. We should show contentment and not be envious of others. We should not crave material things or be motivated only by financial gain. We are to be an example of one who puts spiritual things first, meaning our treasures are in heaven and in the hope of the resurrection. But there are other possibilities as well. Why might people be uninterested in hearing, believing, and obeying the gospel? Well, maybe they see hypocrisy among religious people, which certainly does exist. So we need to be sincere and genuine in the execution of our faith. Perhaps they have a past negative experience with other Christians or another church, which sadly does sometimes happen. So we need to be an example of faithfulness and kindness and goodness to them. Other possibilities could be added to this list as well. But the point is that in every interaction we have with others, we're trying to work on making them more receptive to the message of the gospel that we hope to share with them. And when they are interested, we want them to know that they can turn to us and trust us to direct them in the right way. Friends, we want to thank you for joining us for our program today. We pray that you will consider these things that we've discussed, and that God will bless you with a wonderful day.